What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 9 of the Rags to Riches series with Real Oviedo. I've now done the next 10 games in the second half of the season, so let's get straight into it. As everyone would remember, last game was Conquense away. Unfortunately, we lost that one. And first game of this one was Xerez in the Federation Cup. As you can see, I actually won 2-1 away from home. Diego Sarajevo actually missed a penalty after 10 minutes. But 17 minutes later, he redeemed himself by putting us 1-0 up. And that's how it was up until halftime. And then Xavi Moore, in the 66th minute, put us 2-0 up. Iniego Velez did pull one back for Xerez, but it was in the last minute, so it wasn't enough. And we ran out 2-1 winners, which is good in a two-legged affair, especially as the away goals do count. Shots wise, it's 12-9 in their favour. We both had 5 shots on target each, and possession was theirs, 52-48. And we then followed that up with a 1-0 defeat at home to Caruxo in the league. Quite annoyed with this one. Alvaro Cano actually scored in the 53rd minute to give them the win. It was 10-9 in my favour, 5-4 on target in my favour, and 51-49 in my favour as well. So I was disappointed to lose 1-0. We then followed that up with the second defeat in a row, 1-0 at Fuenlabrada. A Sergio Pachon goal in the 13th minute from the penalty spot gave him the win. Disappointed the fact that we didn't convert more chances, or make more chances anyway. 8-6 in my favour, 4-1 on target in their favour. So 8-1 on target is pretty rubbish. Possession 51-49. The next game was the second leg of the Federation Cup second round, home to Xerez. Pepe Diaz put me 1-0 up in the 4th minute. Israel did pull one back for Xerez, and it was 1-1 at half time and 3-2 on aggregate. And luckily, Carlos Madeira, who was playing due to me resting some strikers and some midfielders, gave me a 2-1 win in the 17th minute and a 4-2 win overall on aggregate. It was quite lucky, to be fair. 11-6 in their favour, 6-3 on target in their favour. But I had the more possession, 53-47. So that 2-1 win put me through to the quarter-final, where I would face Barcelona's B team. I then followed that up with a comfortable 4-0 win in the league at home to Lanzarote. Pepe Diaz put me 1-0 up. Diego Sarajevo missed another penalty, and we went into halftime with 1-0. Diego Sarajevo then made amends again for missing the penalty by scoring on the arrow mark. Diaz got his second and our third in the 73rd minute, and Manu Booster round off the goals with a goal, fourth goal, a minute from time. 20-12 in my favour, 9-4 on target in my favour, and 59-41 possession wise. Lanzarote are pretty much already relegated, to be fair. But it was good to get back to winning ways in the league. I then followed that up with a 3-1 win at Guajillo. Sarajevo in the 5th minute, Mustafi in the 24th, and Ivan Rubio actually rounded off the goal scored in the first half. So 3-0 up after 32 minutes. It's 10-6 in my favour, 5-3 on target in my favour, but they had 54% of the possession. I then had the first leg of the quarter-final of the Federation Cup at Barcelona B, and this was really, really annoying. Barca B have done very well in the league. I think they've only lost one game all season, so last I checked, well, before this game anyway, and I lost 3-0. But it doesn't tell all of it. Sergio Arujo put Barca 1-0 up, but it was 1-0 until the 90th minute, and then Hurtas and Abuele, 2 goals in 2 minutes in added on time, gave Barca a 3-0 win. I was really annoyed they scored 2 goals so late on. And it was 18-12 in my favour, in their favour, sorry. 6-5 on target. They scored half of theirs and I didn't even score, which was frustrating. and possession wise was 51-49. So I was really, really annoyed with that game. Despite that, we went to Pontevedra, who again are struggling. Whoops. Pontevedra, who are just as bad as Lanzarote. And a Diego Cerezo double gave me a 2-0 win and made it three league wins in a trot. 11 shots each and 6-5 on target in my favour. Possession was 55-45 in their favour. So that made it three league wins in a row. As you guys may have just seen, the second leg of the quarter final was a lot different. I was actually I was level on aggregate in the first half hour of the actual game. Raul Ruiz in the 11th minute, 11 minutes later, he then doubled the lead. And then 9 minutes later, he actually pulled us level on aggregate to make it 3-3. And I was having chance after chance after when second in the second half, I was chance after chance. And typical football manager qualities coming through. Araujo scored Barca's first highlight in the second half to give them the goal they needed. And I mean, here's proof here. 16 shots to 11. 8 shots to 3 on target in my favour. And 3-1 put them through. Possession wise 54-46. So I was pleased to come back from that. I wasn't expecting us to get back to 3-3 in the first half. But Taruja's goal made it 4-3 on the night and gave Barca the win. I went all out of attack. I would have needed 2 goals because obviously Barca had the away goal, but just wasn't to be. And I think that's the quarterfinals like last year, we got knocked out in as well. Returned to league action after that, and we beat Atletico B in a televised game. Atletico were top, if I remember rightly, this time were second. Pepe Diaz put me 1-0 up in the 67th minute. Borja equalised for Atletico B 7 minutes later. But 9 minutes from time, Pepe Diaz got a second to give us a 2-1 win. It's 14 shots to 5 in my favour. 8 shots to 2 on target in my favour. And 51-49 possession-wise in my favour as well. We then beat Avilés 2-0 at home. 0-0 at half-time. Alex Cruz put me 1-0 up, an own goal actually from their centre back, I believe, one of the defenders, 63rd minute. And then Diego Cerezo doubled the lead 10 minutes later. Match stats wise, 12 shots each, 6-5 on target in my favour, and they had 51% of my 49% possession. That was 5 wins on the bounce in the league. Unfortunately, since then, it's not gone well. I then went to Cadal in the league, and I was 0-0 at half time. And ended up losing 4-0. An own goal by my centre back a minute after half time put them in front. And then 3 goals in 12 minutes. Typical football manager stuff again. 73rd minute, Josete made it 2-0 to them. And then Silenus made it 3-0 in the 78th minute. And then 7 minutes later, finished off the score in 4-0. And stats wise, 16 shots to 11. 8 shots to 4 on target in their favour, so they scored half their goals or half their attempts on target. And possession wise is 51-49% to me. I then drew my first league game of the entire season. RSD Akalau away. Borja Rubutio put them 1-0 up in the 42nd minute. And a Shoko Mustafi equaliser 3 minutes and added on time actually pulled me back to 1-1. Shots were 17-9 in my favour, 6-3 on target in my favour, and 52-48 possession wise. And the last game of this section was another defeat at home to Marino, 2-1. Was 0-0 at half time, but then Juanma put them 1-0 up just before the hour. Alessio Bonjour made it 2-0, 68th minute. 5 minutes later, Cerezo pulled one back for me. But we couldn't make our chances pay after that. 14 shots to 10 in their favour. 5-3 on target in their favour. Possession wise was 55-45 in their favour. So, bit of a rubbish end. That's probably the worst section I've had, if I'm being honest. Well, actually, it's not too bad. Five wins, 1 draw, 4 losses. So, actually, that's not too bad. And obviously, going out of the Federation Cup. In the semis, Barca got Gimnastica and they've already beaten 3-1, so I get the feeling they're actually going to win the whole thing, to be honest. In the league, I am 4th in the final playoff spot, but I'm 5 points clear of Fulham Brada, with 9 games to go, so that should hopefully be enough. I would like to get 5 more wins at least to pretty much guarantee myself in that playoff spot. I think it's safe to say Albacete are now going to win the second division B1 and go into the winners section. Let's have a look at some of the other divisions. So B2, you've got Alaves, who are top, 7 points clear, and I think it's just going to be between them and Gimnástica for the top spot. B3, Barcelona B, as you can see, you're 9 points clear of Alcoyano. I think they've pretty much guaranteed they're going to finish top. And then you've got Alcoyano and Mallorca's B team, Villarreal's B team. And then in second division B4, you've got Betis's B team, who are top, 6 points clear, with Xeres, Cartagena and Cadiz in the playoff spots. Just have a look at how Salamanca are doing in the Segunda division. So they're 3 points, they're 2 points from safety, and it's not doing too bad, to be fair. And you've also got Castilla. Of all the teams that went up, you've got Gimnástica in 11th, Tenerife 15th, Eibar and Salamanca. And actually La Liga, Real Madrid top by 6 points. Barca in 2nd, you got Mallorca, Girona and Celta Vigo in the bottom places. I'm going to go in a bit more detail for all the leagues at the end of the next video, because the next video will culminate in me finishing the season. If I make the playoffs again, I will do a playoff special like last time. I think what I might do this time though is maybe start the video with actually the draw for the playoffs, or I might do that at the end of the next one. Not too sure, we'll see after how it goes. But that's it for this video, guys. Leave some likes, leave some comments, and tune in next time for the end of the season update and see how we're doing. Check it out.